Alright, so here we have the video that I recorded quite a while ago, and now I'm going to talk over in commentary. So I'm going to explain here why I chose certain parts to build my RC car and upgrading it and everything. So basically it's just a Traxxas Rustler that I got several years ago, and it's been upgraded to brushless, and I have changed almost all of the parts to custom parts. So there's a couple things which I have not changed, and I'll talk about here. So the chassis is still the original one, and I've not changed any of that, as well as the front bumper. That's still the one that came with the car. Controller, still the stock controller, and the gearbox at the back over here. This one has not changed at all. I would like to buy the new Proline gearbox, but yeah, I haven't had time to do that yet. I might in the future, but yeah. So you can see that's stock radio and receiver, and I've got a pretty powerful brushless system in here. So this is just a 1/10 scale dynamite RC fuse brushless, a motor and ESC, 6,800 kilovolt, and it gives pretty high RPM, low torque. But I gear it down so it still goes pretty fast. And basically, almost all the parts on this car are aftermarket parts. So yeah, let's go over and see what there is. So starting off with the tires, these are Traxxas black chrome wheels and Proline Street Fighter tires. So these are 3.3 inches. And they work really well for asphalt and basically doing speed runs on the track like you saw at the start of this video. And over here I also have some Proline Badlands tires. So these are 2.2 inch wheels. You can see I've used these quite a bit off-road. So these are for off-road only, and they'll totally get ruined if I use them on concrete or stuff. But they're really nice because they're also a bit larger. So they put your car up a bit higher, and that works good for off-road. Lots of traction and stuff. And over here, I have the stock tires. I actually have a new pair of these, front and rear, on black chrome wheels that I bought new. But these ones are my old ones originally. Very worn out. You can see the red line I drew on there with a Sharpie. So I basically just use these for off-road, dirt, and on-road all at the same time, because they're already worn out, so it doesn't really matter. And if I don't want to bother changing them, these are the wheels I use for everything. And over here, so let's see, taking a look at the shocks. These are Proline shocks. I can't remember their name, but they only have like one set of shocks, front and rear. On the rear, I've got hard springs for the front, top and bottom. And on the front, I have medium. And the reason for that is because that big nickel metal hydride battery over there is pretty heavy. So I need something to push that weight up until I upgrade to LiPo, which I haven't yet. But it's pretty balanced. You can see here, center, everything has nice suspension. The front doesn't bottom out, but the rear does when doing jumps. So I might need some thicker oil, but really the thing that will help most is upgrading that old battery to a LiPo battery. But those are pretty expensive, and when I bought these batteries, I actually didn't have a LiPo charger, so I was like, I'm not going to spend $200 on batteries and a LiPo charger, but I might in the future. At the front over here, we got the fiberglass tie bar to improve rigidity, and that thing over there, wrapped in duct tape, is actually a block of lead. So it's just a small block of lead, wrapped it in duct tape so that I don't have to touch it, because lead's toxic. And this way it adds a bit of weight to the front so that the car is a bit more balanced, and also stays a bit on the ground more when going really fast, like 60, 70, 80. You want to have those front tires on the track so that you have a steering control. So farthest pin out for the front shocks, closest pin in for the rear shocks. That's how I've got mine set up. And I think it's 45 thickness oil. Inside the tires over here, you can see it's all aluminum. So I've got the hex wheel hub blue anodized, as well as the axle carrier and the caster block. And then also the bars are also blue anodized aluminum. At the rear, we've got also blue aluminum axle carriers and steel constant velocity drive shafts, all upgraded ball bearings as well. So it's very smooth, very nice power transmission. So good for high torque applications like this. And it's also very smooth when going really quickly. So that's very nice. And over on the other side, oh, this is gonna get a little blurry over here. Camera's not gonna focus. But yeah, all steel. It's very nice. I'll have to upgrade that gearbox soon because I don't really like the stock one. It's not very nice. And yeah, but transmission is smooth. It's got the metal gears inside, so that's going well. Planetary differential, and over here on the motor, as I said, it's 6,800 kilovolts, goes pretty fast. And over there's a fan, the dynamite fan on it as well. Up to 3S on the ESC, I think it's a 150 amp ESC. And it's got a little fan on it as well, to prevent it from overheating. I might change that fan to a larger one though in the future, because you can see the heat sink's a lot bigger than the fan. And it's got some double-sided tape and the switch on off. And over here, now going to the other side, you'll see there's this, well, let's take another look at the battery over there, the connector. And over here, there's some metal wire. I actually just used a strong piece of wire stuck there so that it actually holds the battery connector in place. And the reason I did this is because when going at really high speeds and turns off-road, on that, all the connector would just stay up like that, and it would just bounce around, and that's not very good. So I wanted to keep it secure, and this wire does the job. So holds it in over there, but it's still easy to remove and disconnect. Over here, you'll see the upgraded servo 2075, and an aluminum servo horn from Axial. Was actually a bit longer than it was than it would fit there, so I actually had to trim it down, file it, and now it fits. Over there, we've got a Pro Line, a bell crank. Yep. And it's got an integrated servo saver, so that's very nice. And yeah, also all the shock towers are upgraded RPM plastic, and also the rear and front A-arms are also all RPM plastic. These are very, very strong, very flexible. I originally wanted to have them be a blue anodized aluminum, but plastic's actually a lot better for shock towers and A-arms because it's flexible and won't snap. It will actually bend instead of snap. So that's a lot more durable. Over here, you can see the gearing. It's a bit too high for this high RPM motor. I think I have 86 to 23 there. And yeah, I would probably need a bigger battery or some smaller gearing to make this run optimally, because it was overheating a bit after like 10 or 20 runs at the track. So not the best gearing, but hopefully someday I'll upgrade this to a Mamba Monster setup, and those high torque, low RPM motors actually overheat a lot less. So that's gonna be an improvement. But for now, I was just experimenting with gearing, finding out what works best and all that. I usually run it at much lower, so around like, I think I have some other gears that we'll show you guys later. But yeah, that's gearing that I had on for those speed runs. Over here, we're gonna talk about the two batteries I have. So this is a 7-cell 5,000 milliamp hour NMP battery, and here's an 8-cell. So we have 8.4 volts and 9.6 volts for two batteries with the Traxxas connector, and they run pretty fast. They last about an half an hour to an hour at full speed, so that's very nice. But I do need to upgrade to LiPo batteries sometime in the near future now that I have this awesome charger over here, which I'll show you guys in a second. Just following along with the video, and here we go. Yeah, this is a Traxxas 6 amp Easy Peak Plus. I used to have the 4 amp version just for charging batteries, but I decided to buy this one because I needed to charge many different types of batteries. So this one has swappable banana plugs for connectors. You can put in any connector you want. You got the balancing port for lithium batteries and controls. You have DC power in, AC power in. It's got a fan on the back, and I think it can use 110 to 240 volts, so all over the world. Little fan over there keeps it cool, and yeah, so it's a very, very capable charger. Can charge almost any kind of battery, so that's why I bought it. And you can see, got the controls over here, and basically this is just starting it up. So it's got a bunch of presets. You can save and load data of what batteries you're going to charge. You have a bunch of different types: nickel metal hydride, nickel cadmium, lithium polymer. You also have a lead acid batteries, which is why I first bought this charger. But yeah, lots of different types, and you can have them balance in different ways. You can have charge discharge cycles, save different capacities and all that. You can see I have that here. I have several presets. So this is basically the best charger I've had, and it works for everything. Over here is the stock controller that I have not upgraded yet. I would like to buy a DX4S or 4R, but those are $300, $400 controllers. So hopefully sometime in the future, if I'm rich, then I'll probably upgrade to one of those. But this has been doing me fine for now. Works pretty good. The farthest I've used my car is like 100, 150 meters away on the track, and it seems to cover the range all the way up to there perfectly fine. So 27.145 megahertz is what I'm stuck with for now. And I have the throttle, if this focuses, set at 70/30, a lot better than 50/50. Hopefully, yeah. Anyways, that we got the nice steering wheel. So yeah, it's not definitely not the best controller, but it's worked for me, and had no issues with it. So I'll have to upgrade that in the future. Okay, so here we're taking a look a bit more at the suspension. You can see the rear of the car goes down pretty low and actually bottoms out. You can see it touches the ground, and when doing jumps, that's not very good. But luckily, there's a piece of plastic there protecting the motor, so it's not going to damage the components or anything. Just scratch the bottom a bit. And yeah, I got some Proline stickers on the side over there. Yep. Pretty smooth. And all right. So here I have different gears. I have a set. I think this is 16 tooth. And then we have 18, 19, 20, 21. I got like a small set. Yeah, 18, 19, and 20, 21. And over here we have a 90 tooth spur gear. So I also got this one. Sometimes I run 16 to 19, 90 for off-roading so that I have a lot of extra torque, and it actually goes really fast off-road, even though it's a high RPM, low torque motor. Still does pretty good with the low gearing. And you can see the gears that I actually bought are not as wide as the stock gears. The teeth are only like, I think, 3/4 as tall or half, but it still works fine. Haven't had any issues with them. And yeah, it's nice to have a choice of what gearing to use, experiment what works best, and different gears for different occasions, such as off-roading, speed runs, regular, just casual running and play and stuff. So yeah, very nice. And over here, we're gonna go over to Custom screws, yes. So, bunch of hex screws. I bought stainless steel hex screws because the regular Phillips head screws I had stock were stripping a bit. So I decided just to buy a full set and replace everything with nice hex screws. A lot better, easier to put together and pull apart everything. And it comes with ton of them, more than you actually need, but you have a bunch of whole choices of what to use, and overall improves the build quality of the vehicle, so that's very nice. All different types for the different parts of the car. Comes with some hex Allen wrenches, so very nice. And yeah, so at this point, I'm just going to show you guys a bunch of pictures. I hope you enjoyed. And I guess I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye.